This is an artillery strike going in the Delta. I think we're working with the 9th Infantry then, south of Saigon. See the artillery as it hits the real marshy area and monsoon area. Flying with Jack Schweizer, pilot, flying a gunship. Right after the artillery strike, we're going in to soften the area again before the troops come in, shooting rockets, 2.75-inch rockets, door gun or mini guns. You'll see that in a few minutes. But you see all the water. It's really marshy, and you might think, well, it's kind of hard for anybody to be down there. But surprisingly, the Viet Cong can really hide in that nip of palm and in the dike lines and tunnels. It's amazing where they can be. This is the one of the crew chief getting ready to mark the LZ with yellow smoke. We're coming in real for a low pass, marking the landing zone for the lead aircraft. There is a door gun, which is a minigun. Tremendous weapon. You can see the barrel's spin puts out 4,000 rounds per minute. Good crew chief could write his name in the water with that thing. It's amazing. You can see the spray. Again, prepping the LZ. There was and there's our wingman going for, he just finished a pass, and we're coming in now. See the door gun, bullets, rocket fire, right at the edge of the landing zone. Quite a bit of mud there, too. We had to watch out, do a fairly sharp turn, keep from hitting the mud from the blast, because it can knock out your windshield, knock out your chin bubble. One rocket went high there. But that was quite a bit of nip-bomb, quite an area for hiding. Now we're working with the infantry company down in the Delta with the 9th Infantry, and they set up a temporary support base for us. I had four gunships, 128th Assault Helicopter Gunslingers was our code name. Came in to rearm and refuel. Some of the guys there, we just finished a mission, come back in to reload. Took about 30 minutes to reload. Machine gun fire. There's the crew chiefs. There's some of the pilots talking. Pete Jansen laughing with his back to us. Larry Wagner talking. Both those guys had been shot in the legs. Larry had been shot through both legs with one bullet a few months earlier. Went into the hospital, came back, came to us. He was with a different unit that time. Pete got shot in the leg once before this filming and once after.